Hello, this is Avinash Gorakshekar from ProfitMart Securities. Last week, the market closed with marginal losses amid a lot of volatility, and especially we saw sectors like pharma, IT continuously under pressure. Globally also, there was a lot of inconclusive development on the fiscal stimulus from the US, as well as some more fears coming from the US-China trade developments, and that affected the sentiments. Both the Nifty as well as the Sensex saw a little correction, and we saw selectively frontline as well as mid-cap counters showing a marginal to moderate kind of correction. Coming week, we believe that sectors like chemicals, sectors like infrastructure, and specifically companies relating to the optic fiber products are going to be in focus. This is largely because what the Prime Minister Narendra Modi has commented on the Independence Day of focusing more on the infrastructure and optic fiber kind of development. This is definitely going to impact positively on companies, especially like Sterlite Tech, which is a large player in the private sector the space. More importantly, on the telecom side, the AGR case has now got shifted to Monday, that is that is 17th August, and we believe that the development on this front is going to be extremely important for players like Vodafone and Bharti Airtel. One new development which has come in is Reliance Industries, where the matter is yet sub judice, and where Reliance Communication dues have been requested from Reliance Industries, considering the kind of spectrum they purchased from Arcom. Although this news is not completely confirmed, and we may see some clarification coming from both sides, we may see a little bit of correction on the Reliance counter also. Coming to the coming week, our sense is that there will be a more of a stock specific activity, because more than 200 odd companies will be declaring results. Our sense is that the index may move in a very narrow range, and we may not see a very significant upside beyond 11,400. And on the downside, 11,000 would be a level to watch carefully. So the markets could trade definitely with a very volatile kind of bias. In the coming week, we believe that mid-caps, which have shown a lot of promise, should continue to do well. And within this space, we like a company called Nesco. Now, Nesco is basically into, IT parks. They run the Bombay Exhibition Center. They also have a food division, which is called Nesco Foods. Recently, the company came out with very strong performance numbers for the June quarter, despite the fact that this was a very bad quarter considering the lockdown effect. The company has posted a 15% increase in top line, roughly around 92 crores, and the bottom line has actually grown remarkably well at around 51 crores. The management commentary has also been very strong. The company expects that they would do better despite the COVID-19 problem. And hopefully FY21 second half should be a much better period. In fact, our sense is that within the mid-cap space, this is a quality mid-cap, and valuations are trading at fairly attractive levels. The stock has seen a bump up from almost 450 odd levels to around 510, 517. But we believe that over the next, say, 12 to 15 months, hopefully once normalcy comes in, there could be a significant re-rating from these levels, considering that Nesco is a debt-free company. It has cash of almost 650 to 700 crores on the books. And we believe that over the next, say, 12 to 15 months, a target price of at least 700 rupees looks possible. So this could be a good stock to focus from a purely investment point of view, and can give good returns over the next 12 to 15 months. So friends, that's it from my side. Thank you very much.